Heikinashi candlesticks. That's what we're talking about today. This is part two of a three-part series. If you want to see part one, go to the description down below, and I have put a link to it. But you can watch these in any order, so go ahead and finish this video first. So today, what we're going to talk about is using Heikinashi candlesticks as triggers to enter a trade. And here is the pattern we're looking for. We're looking for a specific pattern on the bar. And it has a couple of characteristics. So let's say we want to go short, and this is the pattern right here. And there's two main characteristics of the bar itself, and then we have to look at the bigger context of the chart. So the two characteristics of the bar itself is that, first of all, there is no wick on the top. Now, this would be for a short. So there's no wick, absolutely zero wick, not even a little itsy-weensy one. And that's very important. Even if you got a little tiny wick up there, you could barely see it's one pixel high. No, that disqualifies it as a short trigger bar. It can have a wick on the bottom. And this is bearish. So this is the bearish pattern. And again, one way to kind of think of this is the top or the bottom. Where is the wick? The wick's on the bottom. So you can think of that wick as an arrow and say, okay, so that's indicating that's a short trigger. And again, no wick on the top. So that would be your short. Okay, now the other characteristic other than just no wick on the top would be that it has to be somewhat of a wide range bar. You don't want a narrow range bar. Narrow range bars are just neutral. So for example, even this one, you know, that one's just kind of narrow range. That one's kind of narrow range. So no, I don't use those. I wait for these, you know, really strong signals. Okay, so wide range bar, at least medium range bar, no wick on the top for a bearish trigger. And by the way, conversely, we would want no wick on the bottom for a bullish trigger. So that's right there. Okay, that would be your bullish trigger. No wick on the bottom, wick on the top. And by the way, this can, as you can see here, this could just be a scalping. Could be a Heikinashi scalping strategy. Doesn't mean that this is not a long-term indication, in other words. In our trading systems, we have several tools that we need to use. So everything must be done in the context of the chart. And so the Heikinashi here, it's just giving you a short-term trigger to get in. Doesn't tell you how long it's going to. Now, actually, in part one, I kind of gave you an indication there as to how to stay into trends when they do go for a long time. But that first Heikinashi bar is not going to tell you how long that trend's going to last. It can give you an indication of when it's going to end, but the first bar doesn't. You got to keep watching it bar by bar to look for that end of the trend. All right, so you'll see that in part one if you haven't already. So then we just, now the other part of it is we have to trade this in the big context of the chart. So for example, trend. This would be one way to get into a big move is to say, well, do we have a trend? And are we early in a new trend? So you can use whatever trend indication that you want to. If you have one you already like, great, use it. And I just have the 15 EMA here, exponential moving average. Not saying it's the best. It's not even really what I personally use for a trend, but I use it as a relative strength indication of the retraces in the trend. So as long as we keep going down, 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 cool, we're golden. But now we've got to look at one more thing so that you, again, understand what I mean by trading this in the context of the chart. So we have a bearish Heikinashi bar here. We'll just take, we could take several of them. We could look at that one. We could look at this one, right? Would I take these short? No way. No way. Absolutely no. Why? Okay, can you think of why? Think of it in your own mind. See if you can come up with a reason why, because I'm about to tell you. See if you can come up with it without me telling you anymore. Giving you a little hint with that long arrow, because as you've probably heard, the trend is your friend until the end. So this is a trigger to get into a new move. Think of it that way. We don't want to get in to trades that are late in an old trend. They're less probable to continue. So I only look for these trigger bars, these Heikinashi candlesticks, early in a new trend, because that's when I want to get in on the big pattern, the meta pattern of whatever charge you're taking. All right, so I only take it early as possible in a new indication of a trend. After that, I don't take them anymore. So it's very important. By the way, another little tip for you is that, as I explained in the first video, these Heike-Nashi bars are not the actual price of the market. So you got to be a little careful with that. But also, what that means is that if you have a counter, something that, like, I got my own top dog counter. So what that means is, okay, this is a 2-minute chart. So each one of these bars represents 2 minutes. But not really. With Heike-Nashi, it messes things up. Because again, these is not the actual high-low close of the market. It's run through a calculation, a formula. So technically, you could kind of call Heike-Nashi candlesticks indicators, but they're indicators on the bars themselves. So counters do not tend to work on Heike-Nashi bars. So your countdown timers, in other words, if you've got countdown timer, again, this is 2 minutes, starts out with 2 minutes. 1 minute 59 seconds, 1 minute 58 seconds, 1 minute 57 seconds, 56, 54, all the way down to zero. Usually, I mean, I've never seen it work on any trading platform. Maybe there's one out there that can do it. But anyway, if you put your counter on with Heike-Nashi's and that doesn't show over here a countdown, that's why. All right, because again, it's calculating two bars together. Now, let's look at one more thing here. It's very important. So another part of the trading business is not only knowing when to get in, but also when to stay out of the market. And Heike-Nashi bars can do a pretty good job of that as well. So for example, let's look at this whole pattern here. So, okay, big dramatic move. By the way, another thing that's important to understand with Heike-Nashi bars is you will never get gaps because it averages two candles together. You will not see gaps. They will not be plotted on your chart. All right, so having said that, we definitely have a big dramatic move down, very visible. All right, then we come across here. Now, look, this whole time here, where should we go? I don't know, just randomly draw it there. So our 15 EMA is still going down, so we don't have an uptrend. And our Heike-Nashi bars are just very narrow range, so just the opposite of what we're looking for in a trigger bar, narrow range instead of wide range. And most of them, so that just is neutral. Okay, so that's the kind of market I'm going to stay out of. I'm not going to take a trade during that. Now, I may wait and watch this and wait for a first good bearish bar, but during this time, I'm going to keep my powder dry. No way. Same thing over here where we have bars. I mean, gosh, just look at all of these in what we've got here. I didn't really draw that very well. Let me do that again for you to be precise. All right, so yeah, let's just put it up here a little bit further. Okay, so all these bars, now there's a couple things. So not only do we have narrow range bars, but we've got these bars where the real body is narrow range, and there's the bars are wide range, but the real body is narrow range, and got big wicks above, big wicks below. Again, I consider those to be neutral as far as direction goes. The 15 EMA is flat, so there's no longer term directional indication anyway, and I would just stay out of all that junk. So this is another benefit, is not only can it give you signals to get in early in a new trend, but it can keep you out of noisy markets. So if you've ever had the experience where you start making some money and then you give it back, make some money, give it back, make some money, give more back, that's no bueno, right? We all hate that. This is one way to stop giving some money back. Now, as I said, this is one piece of a trading system. If you'd like to get more of my trading methodology, I've got a fantastic, actually, a trade. I'll just give you a trade where I give you all the details of the trade. It's called the rubber band trade. So go check it out. Go to, well, there's the URL right there, URL there for you. And, or you can just go to rubberbandtrade.com if you'd like, either way. And I'll give you the whole trade setup, all the details, and let's make you some money before you spend any more money. Try it on a demo account or similar account, obviously, first, and I look forward to helping you.